And it says, and he saw them toiling and rowing, for the wind was contrary unto them.
Yes.
But about the fourth watch of the night, he cometh unto them, walking upon the sea, and would have passed them by. Now we say we want some things from the Lord. We want God to move on our behalf. But if we don't cry out, God will pass us by. So what we need to do is cry out unto God. When we cry out unto God, God moves. Now blind Bartimaeus was a blind man, wanting Jesus to do a miracle unto him. Now when he went unto this crowd, when Jesus was teaching, this man was being charged by the men and by the people standing in that place. They charged him over and over again, but still blind Bartimaeus still stood firm on what Jesus was saying. He stood on the word. And guess what? When he stood on that word and they charged him, even being blind, he kept moving. He kept pushing. Because he knew at the end, there would be a healing. There would be a miracle already waiting for him. We need to speak those things as though they were. And they shall come to pass. If we speak those things with our words, carry power. They can bring life or blessings or death and curses. Our mouths have power. Now, if they would have passed them by, if they really wanted something from Jesus, they would cry out. But if they didn't cry out, they obviously didn't need anything from Jesus. So as far as Christians to get on our knees and to our face and to get crazy with the Lord and cry out unto him, and everything that we ask him shall come to pass. And will come to pass. We're going to read a couple more scriptures and we're going to finish this third. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And it says they was walking unto him. They was troubled. They thought it was a spirit, so they cried out for fear. But Jesus spake these words, 27, and be of good cheer in his eye. Be not afraid. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou. Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. Now the water represented the word. When we are called forth into a ministry to do the work of God, we must be solidly firm and grounded, set and fully persuaded in the word. Because when we walk on this word, we can never go wrong. God said in 2 Peter, if we do these, we shall never fall. God is looking for us to come to a perfection. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect. God is looking for us to be on one mind, one accord, not shaking, standing on what God has given us. And then we can be successful. Because in Acts they had power. They healed people. People were delivered. People were set free. Miracles happened supernaturally. But how? Because they was on one mind. And Jesus had said, Peter had said, Lord, if it be thou. Peter was saying that word that you had said to me before when you first had called me. Give me that word again. Amen. He was looking for that word. It says in the scripture, my sheep hear my voice and a stranger they will not follow. Now when Jesus gave that word, he stood on that word and walked the whole way.
Hallelujah.
But the only time we're going to shorten this up, but the only time when he failed is when he took his eyes off of Jesus. The only time we will fail is when we take our eyes off from Jesus. So we need to keep our eyes on Jesus. And I promise you that when you keep your eyes on Jesus, you shall never fail. You shall never fall. God is looking for us to be bold in these last days. Men shall give ear to seducing spirits. Men will turn away from natural affection. These things are already spoken of in the Bible. But it's for us to stand firm on this word and walk on the water and not be shaken by what happens. God bless you. And I hope these short words of encouragement with these few scriptures bless your soul. Just to walk on and carry on and keep fighting the good fight of faith. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. And keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep God first. And all these things shall be added unto you.